much for giving me this opportunity.、I'm Akihiro Ondo, the Managing Director and CEO of Mitsubishi Power、Asia Pacific. I currently lead the team、over the 1,200 members across the region. And、we provide the、customized、power generation solution、to meet the、unique features or surroundings of each country or each client in the region. In the beginning,、I want to provide an overview、in the region. So still,、most of the countries in the region has a stable economic growth.Then、having the increased、power demand, electricity demand. So to meet、such demand、with providing、reliable and efficient、power, electricity is quite important. At the same time, we have to always address to the、sustainability, including the decarbonization. Then from this standpoint,we are focusing on、three areas. So the first area is to offer our latest and、high efficient and high reliability、gas turbine combined cycle. So that we provide、such、our latest model, the heavy duty、gas turbine combined cycle, then it can、automatically reduce the 65% carbon dioxide compared with the conventional the coal firing facility. So that with providing、this solution, that we can、simultaneously meet the needs for both、electricity、energy security and also the sustainability. Then about the second area, that we are also focusing onThe improvement of、existing facilities. We offer the upgrading、application for existing gas turbine or steam turbine to improve the efficiency. Then, if we can improve the existing facility, then、we can reduce the fuel consumption in the same ratio. Also,、we are、providing theAI-based、operation and maintenance、support programs that we call it TOMONI. Then with having、such programs, the existing plant can improve the flexibility and also the、operability. Then、we can improve kind of combination with the renewable energies. So that is the second area.Then the last area and the most important area is we are conducting the, a lot of verification activity to accommodate the clean fuels, the hydrogen and ammonia. So the, we, our gas, latest model gas turbine has a capability to co-fire the 30% hydrogen.Even today. Then we are continuously、conducting our、verification activity to increase the ratio to have hydrogen to 50% and、100% towards、 2030. Also, we、implement the verification to fire 100% ammonia in our smaller、capacity gas turbine.And also the coal fire in the existing、coal facilities. So with having such a verification activity, then we believe that we can、pave the、clear roadmaps、to、validate the technologies、for decarbonization.For, I introduced、several areas, then I would like to、provide a bit more、specific and detailed、 information about our approach. So for gas turbine side, our latest heavy duty gas turbine model is achieving more than 64% power generation efficiency. Then also we are very much proud that the reliability of our such latest model gas turbine is beyond 99.5% reliability over the 2 million hours operation. Then especially this reliability is backed up by our unique approach. So we have a commercial verification plant in our main factory in Takasago, Japan. In this commercial scale verification facility, that we have the long-term technological verification for new arrangement. Then only after 10,000 hours verification, we introduce such new technologies to our customer. So this approach realizes our high reliability, more than 99.5%. Then we can provide the strong contribution to affordability, reliability. So that is our approach about the gas turbines. Also, I mentioned about hydrogen or ammonia. So about the hydrogen side, I mentioned that we have capability 30% co-firing even today. And we provide this application to our customer in Singapore. So we recently received the order from Keppel Infrastructure, Sembcorp Industries, and Meranti Power, that owned by Energy Market Authority in Singapore. Then those the gas turbine facility will be in commercial operation 2025 and 2026. Then all of them has a capability to co-fire the 30% hydrogen even at the time of commercial operation. We also have the unique project in United States that is named Advanced Clean Energy Storage Delta Project, so-called ACES Delta Project. Then this unique project will generate the hydrogen from the renewable energy, then store it underground utilizing the natural salt cavern. Then from this storage facility, the hydrogen will be provided to the gas turbine combined cycle plant. So once through a hydrogen storage and power generation project, that we are providing our gas turbine combined cycle facility, then the project will start the commercial operation from 2025, and with co-firing 30% hydrogen. Then those our approach is again backed up by our verification activity in Takasago. In the same Takasago factory, we have a facility named the Takasago Hydrogen Park. Having the hydrogen production facility, then hydrogen storage, and the generated and stored hydrogen will be injected into the commercial scale verification plant. So we are targeting to complete those technological verifications by 2030. Including the 100% firing of hydrogen. Then we will go into the stage to commercialize those new applications to provide a commercially viable solution to our customers until the 2040. Then we have our own target and commitment named Mission Net Zero as of 2040. So this means we provide a commercially viable solution 10 years earlier than 2050 that most of countries、provide the commitment for net zero. So those are the approach that we are doing、for sustainability side. Then、again, the, we are very much、focusing on the collaboration with our strategic partners. So we have the feasibility study with the IGAD in Thailand,the government-owned utility, PLN Group in Indonesia, then TNB in Malaysia. So with having the verified or studied technologies, we have the feasibility study with such strategic partners, how we can implement such new applications in each countries. So with having those collaborative arrangement, that even involving Japanese government to provide the international financial support to the region, that we would like to aim to aim at achieving the net zero emission goals.We are very much excited and honored to participate in the ENLIT Asia 2023. And we would like to have the dialogue or knowledge sharings with our potential partners or existing stakeholders. Then we would like to try to find the path forward towards the more realisticapproach or realistic pathway to achieve the mission net, sorry, the net zero emission. So that we would like to meet with a lot of members, attendees to the event. Then we hope we can have the, a lot of visitors in our booth, number 1601.